Hello my good friends, Midnight Geek here. This is not the video you wanted, but the video you all deserve. And because a man is known by the games he plays, I want to show you what are my favorite games.
Now listen, and listen good. We have some rules around here.
There are only 3 rules. I won't include multiplayer exclusive games. I'm choosing only one game per entry if the games are similar. And only PC games. Number 10 is Test Drive Unlimited, a game released in 2006 by Eden Games. By who? Exactly. I'm not into racing games, but this one really captured my imagination, allowing me to live the dream of having exotic houses and luxury cars. The game takes place in a handcrafted, lush environment bathed by the sun, more exactly, the Hawaiian island of Oahu. The island is awesome. You have a nice mix of areas, cities, forests, highways, plains, coasts, so races will always feel fresh, although there is a common element, trees, a lot of trees. The cars are split into categories of performance and you have everything from classics such as Aston Martin DB4 GT Zagato and Lamborghini Miura to Ferrari Enzo, Pagani Zonda and Lamborghini Murcielago. My favorite thing to do in this game is drive, just drive, towards objectives, races, houses, showrooms, with the music in my ears and the wind in my hair with my AC97. No, not Realtek AC97, you hopeless geeks, I'm talking about this, the AC97 car. Forced traffic can be very annoying sometimes. Not that traffic can't have a place in this game, but the traffic is changed depending on the race. There are races where there is no traffic, and there are races where there are hundreds of cars on the road. Grand Theft Auto 3 revolutionized open world games, but Rockstar upped their game. Get it? Their game? With Vice City. While GTA 3 took place in a kind of moody and depressing setting, which was awesome by the way, not complaining, Vice City takes place in the shiny 80s. We have everything, palm trees, Miami, beaches, neons and copyrighted music? I'm sorry guys, no Billie Jeans for you today. Although there aren't any new mechanics, we have bikes, we can buy houses, clubs and the game is more expensive than GTA 3. What I really like in this game is the world. I'm a sucker for the 80s style, the vibrant colors which, especially at night, create a sweet spectacle. The town is full of life, unless you get run by the car. People do what people do, and if you suspend your disbelief, you might as well feel like you're living in this world yourself. The story is very well told, of course, when you have voice actors such as Ray Liotta, Burt Reynolds, Tom Sizemore, Machete. Wait, isn't this his name? Oh, sorry. Although starting from nothing and eventually becoming the big boss in town is not such an original concept, the journey towards there is worth all the money.
That was my money, Tommy! My money!
So, my favorite thing. There are a lot of ramps all over town and doing the jumps with the motorcycle is fun, sure. But if you prefer something more exotic, you should take the bus. I would have preferred a bigger and more explorable world. Not that the map is small in itself, but the world is too nice to be that small. People are making fun of Oblivion for the funny faces and the plethora of bugs. But to create this game in 2006 was unheard of. Would you have preferred for Bethesda to create a game with a smaller scope and less bugs and annoyances? I don't. Although I don't quite like enemy scaling, without it you wouldn't be able to explore Zero Deal right from the start. So enemy scaling equals awesome exploration. You don't need the main story. The world is your playground and you can choose your own adventures. Grandiose. This is the word to describe Oblivion. And this is what I like about this game. The sheer scope of it, the exploration and the wow moments. Also, although grand in scale, more often than not, it's the little things that make this game shine. The moment-to-moment encounters, quests, adventures. Games are a means of escape, of experimenting what you can't experiment in real life. That's why roaming the wilds in Oblivion is my favorite thing to do. Pure enjoyment. The Oblivion Gates are a nice concept. Anywhere, anytime, a gate of Oblivion can spawn near you. The sky gets red and dark. The sprawling vegetation feels depressing. Joy has gone out the window. But going inside the gate, you'll see an empty realm, where you'll do the same things over and over again. Find the tower, get the key, punch the slimy flesh, get out. During the period when Grand Theft Auto 3 made headlines and a lot of sales, a Czech game studio, Illusion Softworks, released another open world masterpiece, Mafia. I love three things about this game: the way it feels, the way it looks, and the story. A story about upbringing, family, betrayal, and destiny.
What do they call you, son?
Thomas Angelo.
I've decided to give you a shot, Tommy. I like new faces. New faces.
Set in the 30s, this game immerses you in the troubled life of Tommy Angelo, a hitman for Don Salieri, one of the two Dons that rule the city of Lost Heaven. The game feels and looks like you're in the 30s. All elements create a vortex that sucks you into the game. The cars look awesome. Here are some examples. Not only that, the cars handle like you would imagine a car from that era will handle. They are slow and unstable. The music, which is copyrighted and removed from the game if you're using the GOG or Steam versions, is sublime. Unfortunately, I can't use it on YouTube. Thank you. I can't point to one specific thing in Mafia that I prefer, because Mafia is more than the sum of its parts. That's why I'm going to choose a trip to the country mission as my favorite thing to do in this game. Rome Total War, maybe the best game in the entire Total War series and the one with the highest score on Metacritic. Man, where should I start with this game? Let's talk about the setting. Ancient Rome, the peak of the Roman Empire. This is by far my favorite part in history. Now, take hold of one of the Roman houses, the Julia in the north that hate the Gauls.
Gods, I hate Gauls.
And have nothing in common with Julius Caesar. The Brutia in the south that hate all people.
As if the people mattered. Bah.
And have nothing in common with Brutus. And the Scipia in the further south that have nothing in common with Scipio Africanus and are hated by all people.
Sometimes the hatred of men is stronger.
The campaign map gameplay is turn-based. You conquer cities, build buildings, train armies in order to conquer other cities, to build more buildings and train bigger armies. You get the deal. There are many things that I absolutely adore about this game, but these are the main ones. The Roman Empire period. Is there a better period in history for a real-time strategy? I don't think so. You can experience the rise and the fall of the mighty Roman Empire, you yourself being the protagonist. The big battles, which were revolutionary in 2004. You can have an absurd number of units on the battle map. Just look at this. Imagine being part of a siege of these proportions, you being the general. And the variety of factions and units. Having big armies is nothing if the units are not awesome and varied. Each faction has specific units, although some units can appear in multiple factions. Cataphracts are my favorite thing in this game. No, wait, hoplites. I know. Cataphracts charging into hoplites. Perfection. The AI can be very dumb sometimes, especially on the battle map. Sometimes units will stare like buffoons, other times they will march towards their doom like headless chicken.
Repeat.
There's only one game that I'm trying to finish once a year, and that's Max Payne. The winter holidays are a perfect time to play this masterpiece once again. The atmosphere in this game for me is unique. Max Payne succeeded in pulling me inside its scenes without fancy graphics, a billion polygons on the screen, ray tracing or other eye candy. I'm not dismissing these things, just stating a fact. Besides the excellent atmosphere, I love the bullet time and the gunplay, which is visceral and quick. You can be dead in a few seconds if you're not careful. So, if you're not indulging in some environmental storytelling, maybe it's because you might be taking part in some intense fight scenes.
I didn't like the way the show started. They'd give me the best seat in the house, front row center.
My favorite thing is Max Payne himself, everything about him. How he looks, his voice, the metaphors that he uses, and his dry humor.
The final gunshot was an exclamation mark to everything that had led to this point. I released my finger from the trigger, and then it was over.
I hate something in this game, and I hate it with passion. Auto difficulty. You can dispose of an enemy in one shot, this second, and the same type of enemy will need two or even three shots in the next, because the game sets the difficulty depending on how many deaths you've had for a certain period of time. Ugh. A game which came from the West, Western Europe, Germany more exactly, Gothic 1 was never a smash hit, but over the years it developed into a cult classic. That's because it's simply one of the best open world RPGs out there. I love the setting where the game takes place, inside the big open world prison that's covered by a huge magical barrier, with its own rules and factions.
Out of here or I'll make you run!
The progression in this game is top-notch because you really feel it along the way. You start as the weakest thing in the game that gets beaten to a pulp by absolutely anything, and you end up being the most powerful being through your own merits and hard work.
That was a good hit!
The fight's been decided.
The swamp camp is my favorite thing because the people here are different than the other camps and the place itself looks awesome.
Hi.
The technical stuff. This game is a mess. I won't be going into details, but it had, has, and will have bugs and technical glitches forever. It is what it is. An excellent RPG set in the Star Wars universe. Okay. Knights of the Old Republic, one of the best Star Wars games ever made, one of the best RPGs ever made, one of the best games ever made. Being a Star Wars fanboy, I love everything that BioWare created for this game, and although many areas are boring and repetitive, they give me a sense of something that I can't explain. The companions are great. Their interactions with each other and your interactions with them makes the entire journey a treat and something to look after.
What do you care what happens to some scummy alien? He's just a freak.
I love the fact that you have choices and that the choices are split into good and evil and that the choices matter over the long run. Also, your companions change their beliefs and some of the dialogue, depending on the path you take, towards the light or the dark side.
Come on, let's go. I don't want to listen to this alien lover anymore.
I don't like the stiff AI and controls. The game is old, I know, but even in 2004, the game was not top-notch in this particular area. Also, the collision boxes are extremely bad.
Welcome, Prince Arthas. The men and I are honored by your presence.
Warcraft 3 is Blizzard at its peak. Great world, great story, great gameplay, great everything. What can I say? It's Warcraft 3. We all know it, we've all played it, nothing new here. I really love the heroes and the RPG elements that are seamlessly combined with the strategy side of things. Having heroes with items and spells results in an entirely new way of playing the game. It makes the game interesting, and it also keeps the battles fresh each time.
What kind of nightmare was that?
It was not a nightmare, young war chief, but a vision.
The story of Warcraft 3, Reign of Chaos is wonderful. I care about Arthas, Jaina, Troll, Cairn, Sylvanas, Tyrande, Malfurion, Illidan. I cheer for them when they are waging war. I'm sad when they lose. I cry when they die. I'm happy when they're the hero of the story.
Don't worry, son. We'll find them and bring them home safe.
I don't like the low polygon count.
But geek, it's a game from 2002. Surely you, of all people, won't complain about graphics in such an old game.
No, the visual style is perfect and the game looks amazingly beautiful. I'm talking about this and this and this. Yikes. But before revealing my number one absolute mega uber best game of all temporal and atemporal existence, let's see some mentions that are honorable. Which game is number one was never an issue. I knew it, everyone around me knew it, Diablo 2 Lord of Destruction. The granddaddy of hack and slash games, known in the modern times as action RPGs, yikes. This is the one that started the loot mania, the smash your mouse till it drops, the 0.0001% drop chance of something that increases your power by 2%. Yes sir, Diablo 2 was the first and it has them all. The progression is excellent, you start really weak and make your way towards greatness. The itemization is almost perfect, it's quite balanced from start to finish.
This place is trouble.
Hardcore mode is perfect, although Diablo 2 did not invent hardcore per se, Diablo 2 invented hardcore. You die, you lose the character permanently. There are no turnarounds, no resurrections, no saves, nothing. You lose all your progression and all your items. My favorite thing in this game is Mephisto. Ah, our friend Mephisto, everyone's favorite. He's very nice, we kill him, he gives us items and then respawns, so that we can kill him again and get other items, and so on. The bad stuff? Nothing. This game is literally perfect.
But Nick, the graphics of this game are very outdated. Surely you're not that blind.
You are saying?